Hey everyone, this is Dan, First Person Looter, and I'm starting a brand new game that I haven't played ever before, haven't really even really seen much. I saw what it was rated from IGN, it was an 8. I've heard generally positive things about this game, so I want to give it a try. I just finished the Callisto Protocol, and that was a scary space game, and I thought, maybe try a not-so-scary space game. Now, this is a game I purchased. Leo just freaked out. I purchased this. This is not a PlayStation Plus free game of the month thing. This is from my own money, which might be a mistake because PlayStation Plus is running out, and I'd like to get to all of those games, but this is just what spoke to me at the moment, and maybe I'll hate it and I won't play much of it, but I think I'm gonna like it. So also, I did do the roller coaster in Disney World twice in a row.
Here we go. Try number two.
We cannot stop this unusually large man. Then you're likely doomed.
Drax!
Good luck! You're gonna need it.
As soon as we got off, we went right back on. And I don't like roller coasters, but I like the Guardians of the Galaxy roller coaster. I just don't like drops. But luckily, that ride really didn't have drops. And I was afraid about going backwards, but it feels totally smooth and fine. And I was shocked because I don't like roller coasters. But anyway, that's besides the point. This is Guardians of the Galaxy on the PlayStation 5. Let's do it. I assume I'm gonna be here. Third person, they usually have these people right over there, so let's see what else is going on here. Adjust the brightness to barely see the details on Peter's back. I do barely see the details on Peter's back. Adjust stick sensitivity, inverts, open. I just open the controls. We got this probably. I don't know why this is so quiet in my headphones. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's much louder. Okay. Oh, the people that did Square Enix, the people that did Deus Ex Human Revolution. Oh god, am I gonna get copyright for all the music? Is there a turn off copyrighted music? Oh, he's bobbing his head too. There was a PS4 and a PS5 version that came in my pack. I downloaded the PS5 version, but it doesn't look PS5-y in its quality yet. I'm gonna have to do a lot of muting on audio, huh? Oh my god. Hang in, tough. Oh my god, this is... Oh my god. Okay, I want to experience it with the copyrighted music, so I'll just have to mute it, I guess, when there's copyrighted music. My god, hanging tough. Wow. Kick back and enjoy the story. You're ready to face the galaxy. No one's being the attended Guardians experience. I was talking about this with people. I was tweeting about this. Oh, but you can also kind of tweak it? Wow, that's cool. You can change all of this. Well, I'm gonna leave it as is, and I do wish it was louder. I wish the music was way louder in my headphones. I don't even hear my own voice. I'm mixed all the way to me. Ooh. Oh, it's like the Last of Us house. It's 60p, really? Okay. Is it a little jittering? This looks exactly like the Last of Us house. The tractor right out there. The sunset in that direction. Oh yeah, but the audio is a little out of sync to my headphones as it is to the stream, so I'm probably nodding slightly offbeat. When comes to shift. We'll bring hell down from above. Oh, I don't know. I've never heard this song. To the fire. Are you ready to go, go, go? We'll make a stand. Don't give a damn. This is our time to go from zero to hero. All right. Star-Lord, okay. Let's mix it. 2 years ago, Star-Lord were touring in a Chevy Evanolin van. Four musicians, one faithful road manager, a husky named Coda, and a whole lot of equipment crammed into one vehicle as they drove up and down the West Coast over and over until finally the engine caught fire. Last year they were touring in another eco line. That one was painted orange and nicknamed the Electric Tangerine. But now that their single, Watch Me Shine, has rocketed to the top 10, they've kicked off their first nationwide tour and have a gleaming luxury tour bus, all chrome and aerodynamics. We call it the spaceship, says Steve S., Star-Lord's singer-guitarist, with just the right amount of pomp. There was a lot of hard miles before Star-Lord boarded the spaceship. The story starts back in 1979 when bassist Yannick T and drummer Vince T were two-thirds of a band called the Holy Roaming Empire. You may have noticed the Star-Lord's members eschewed full last names. Air of mystery, dude, Yannick says with a lopsided grin. 2 years later, on a club tour of Canada, they met Steve and lead guitarist Johan B. in Montreal after they performed on the same triple bill everyone went out for pastrami sandwiches at a late-night deli. A few months later, after the lead singer of the Empire had a nervous breakdown and moved to Bora Bora, the surviving rhythm section invited Steve and Johan to come down to L.A. Johan says, the first time we plugged in, we knew it was magic. Or maybe technology that was so advanced you couldn't tell the difference, but probably magic. Calling themselves Star-Lord, they hit the road, opening up for acts ranging from Blue Oyster Cult, Don't Fear the Reaper, to X, to Steel Town Rockers. The band says that the Rockers gig was the only time a crowd chased them off stage. He was really cool about it, Vince says, of guitarist Johnny Digga blah 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 blah. But that whole steel mill crowd was there for the kids, and only them. He shrugs. They earned their name that night. The quartet recorded a demo featuring some of the songs they had hammered out on the road. Bit of Good, Bit of Bad, We're Here, which led to the signing with Amazing Records. Their debut album, Space Rider, released this past October, and the video for Watch Me Shine seemingly played every 20 minutes on MTV, made them overnight successes, if you ignore how it took them about 1,000 overnights to get here. The nerve center of the spaceship is the back lounge. That's where you find Nastasya Kinski, a Nastasya Kinski poster, the TV set usually playing a Richard Pryor video cassette, and Yannick's freaky collection of direwolf bones. And on my third day on the road with Star-Lord, when I've already seen them rock crowds in Milwaukee and Chicago so hard that they didn't know what hit them, after three of the four band members stagger off to their bunks, that's where Steve finally sits down at 4:30 a.m. to talk. There's nobody here except a few ghosts, and I don't care. Let's rap, he says. Where does Star-Lord's name come from? We were sitting around having a few laughs, well, maybe more than a few. Somebody was joking around and said, oh, Steve, you're a real star. And then someone else shouted, yeah, he's Lord of the Stars. We looked at each other and immediately switched it around. Star-Lord. It gave us our identity and even affected our lyrics. What song on the album turned out differently than you expected? The Darkness Inside. It was a personal song about some of the demons and struggles I've dealt with, but I think I imagined it differently when I was writing it. Slower and quieter, maybe because it was written from such a personal place, but Star-Lord is fast and loud. When the band argues, what do you argue about? We get along great. If we do argue, it's usually about who gets the last slice of pizza. Has the band had any run-ins with the law? Being perfectly honest, for me and maybe a few other guys in the band, that would be a solid yes, but I'm not sure it's safe to print. That's a story for another night. We're far from being angels, maybe fallen ones. After hours of late night conversation, the sun rises, the spaceship keeps cruising, Steve looks out the window at Dawn's rosy fingers. I need to sleep before we get to Kansas City, he says, standing up. I do my best work in my dreams. Record review, Star-Lord, Space Rider, amazing records, 3.5 out of 5 stars. That's it after all of that? They only get 3.5? If you're looking to fulfill your recommended daily allowance of guitar-crunching, fist-pumping rock and roll, this promising debut album from Canadian-American quartet Star-Lord has you covered. 10 songs with low nutritional value but plenty of sugar rush. Star-Lord don't reinvent the hard rock genre, but with a soaring anthem like Watch Me Shine, they don't need to. What sets them apart from peers? They live in outer space, with a few exceptions. Combining science fiction with rock and roll has mostly been the purview of prog rock bands. Think Starship Troopers. Oh, I need to play Helldivers too, but Starship Troopers or Set the Controls for the Heart of the Sun. The album-length opus, 2112, Star-Lord... Okay, yeah, Star-Lord embraced those extraterrestrial themes in the name and in their lyrics. Solar Skies begins with frontman Steve S. belting out, "From a dying world they came, a million light years away." But Star-Lord's not into guitar solos that stretch on for 12 parsecs. For this band, sci-fi is the rocket fuel that makes their album rock even harder. Oh, we're like in the 80s, okay.
Birthday boy? No wonder you couldn't hear me. Is that your new tape? Star-Lord? Who's the guy with the scary eyes?
He doesn't have a name. He's one of the Space Riders. And he's not scary, he's cool.
Your Space Rider certainly got his hands full.
He's got a section, his own section of the basement.
Pretty far out.
Nobody says far out anymore, Ma. Ma.
What?
Nobody says far out anymore.
Oh, well, your mom does. Maybe we should see if we could get tickets to see them live.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Your mom may not look it, but I was quite the rocker when I was your age. Your father and I would just lie on the hood of my old Chevy and listen to Black Sabbath and...
You like Black Sabbath?
Like I said, your mom's cooler than you think.
Oh, we'd look up at the stars and he'd tell me all about the places he'd been.
I don't know what happened to him.
Mom?
How about some cake, huh?
Yeah, I'll be up in a sec.
You said that 15 minutes ago.
We're still in first person. Is this going to be a first?
Cake myself.
It's going to be a
first.
Yes, I would.
You wouldn't.
Yes, I would.
Hey, watch the hair.
I know someone who would eat the cake all by themselves.
Oh, Peter! We've talked about you leaving your toys on the floor.
It's toys.
It's an action figure.
More like an action landmine.
Stab your foot. I will.
He doesn't even. Never mind.
13 whole years. Look at you. Where does time go?
I'll be up in a sec, I promise.
Just gotta rub one out real quick. That's cool, he's got his own section of the basement. Exposed wiring, that's fine. Copper pipes, what? There's like a weird texture. Like a moving texture of on the wood. Oh, look at this. There's a cassette recorder. Anything else I can touch? Okay. What if I click on this one first? I guess this lets you... Oh, his cassette recorder can barely even stay together. He's got to have a rubber band hold it together. Let's hear what it sounds like rewinding. That's cool. Is this game in first person? When I had cassette players, I always wanted to... What? Oh, put down. I tried to hit stop. Okay. I would always try to stop it in between songs because I don't want to wear the cassette out in a spot where there was music.
Oh, man, I can't wait to play this. Maybe I can convince
video game power.
Money.
Like Nintendo power. I love Nintendo power too. And I did have a cassette player and I did listen to rock and roll and it was always like the hair bands. I was into Bon Jovi and stuff, but then I started getting into Guns N' Roses and...
This will be worth hundreds of dollars someday.
And then I had a babysitter who said she listened to music that, like, was not appropriate for me, even though I told her I liked Guns N' Roses, which I thought had, like, the most curses and, like, the woman getting, like, basically raped on the inside of her by, like, the robot. It's, like, a famous painting, I guess, or a famous illustration, or well-known, anyway. Not by me as a kid, and that, like, horrified me seeing that. And I was like, oh, there can't be any band any crazier than this with a picture like that. Appetite for Destruction is a title, like, come on. What the hell happened? Do I have a black eye? Oh, no. So I was like, what could be worse than Guns N' Roses? And I never found out what it was. But I mean, I've listened to crazier music since, so I don't know.
Three natural ones in a row last game? Some barn I turned out to be.
And this feels like Last of Us 2, where you walk around your room and...
Crazy that all that destruction started from one little mistake.
Is that supposed to be like Critters? That looks like Critter, but with cat ears. Oh. Down. Ooh, the vibration in the controller feels good.
I need to build up my calluses.
Can I use L to zoom in? Look at this cassette. Yeah, there were so many cassettes that had just a white spine with thick red impact font. Or not, I guess it wasn't impact text. They all had that. Ooh, like baseball cards. I had boxes of baseball cards like this too.
Keep hitting those dingers, George. You'll make it in the Hall of Fame.
Oh my God. This is crazy. I didn't live in the basement, but...
The movie was okay. The soundtrack really kicked butt.
Is that like The Last Starfighter? Is that what that's...
Fingers are still cramped from trying to bookmark pages. I know it's not how you're supposed to play, but I'm tired of dying everywhere.
Dying everywhere. And there's a penguin on the bus. So Penguin Publishing, is that like a choose your own adventure? I love those.
Might as well just peel the stickers off and put them in the right spot.
I considered doing that. But I didn't. And I didn't have jean jackets. Like ripped sleeves, and I wasn't allowed to have long hair till I was much older. I was not 13, and I didn't have. Did I have a mullet? I kind of did, because that was the hair I was allowed to grow long at first. Look, Tron.
Ride one of those light cycles.
And I did that on the same day that I rode Guardians of the Galaxy. I also rode the Tron game.
Welcome to Disney World. Team Blue. Wait, my flashlight's on?
Attention.
Well, that's a real movie, so are these real books, too? Death Trap Dungeon, I guess, might be a real thing. Is Nuke Game a real movie? Are something's real, something's fake? I don't know.
I can't believe I caught this. That Maiden show was awesome.
Oh my God, that looks like the Starfield poster. Holy shit.
The final battle was awesome. Looked like the heroes were done for, but they pulled it off.
Oh, we got the ballad now. Just a little patience, yeah. Or every rose has its thorn. Is that what's your favorite? What, Samantha Fox? Oh my God, okay, wow.
Oh man, traveling through space must be amazing.
SEA. Okay, that sounds like something that'll be in the game. SEA, all right. Funda. Fun Thunder. I want to zoom in. Goodies and baddies. I had a TV like that, a little bit smaller. Jesus Christ. I didn't live in a house with any wood paneling, though. We never became one, never wondered why. Oh, it made me feel so nostalgic. Oh my god.
Get a quill, quill, quill. Get a quill, wake up.
Holy crap, Drax. You gotta stop doing this, man. It's weird.
We are approaching the quarantine zone.
How long was I out for?
15,338 ticks.
That's very specific.
The Betrayer is ready to begin her mission. She has requested your presence in the cockpit.
Gamora's on our side, Drax.
She is the spawn of my sworn enemy, a murderess and a traitor. Do not trust her.
We'll try. We're supposed to be a team.
I make no promises.
I had to check something now. I've missed him. So, was he dreaming about his actual past, or is he calling himself Star-Lord? I guess he took his band's name and that's just what he calls himself. This is first person? Oh, he's got the pin with the triangle-looking thing. That's what you stick in the middle of a record for an old like 6-inch or 45. Look at the old tin. Am I supposed to be doing something? I tried to move it, nothing happened. Do I need to like pull on the left trigger? Let me see what else he has. I'm gonna pull back. That's what it is, okay. It is third person, okay. Oh, Jesus.
Of all the tech we can find.
I pressed X thinking it would open up the door.
It's only illegal if Nova Corps finds us inside, which they won't.
Groot's right to be nervous, Rocket. Don't underestimate the Nova Corps.
Oh, come on. Am I the only one who ain't scared of the Galact?
Ah, there you are, Quill.
Oh, I wanted to hear the rest of it. Dang it.
Arrested.
I am Groot.
I'm not overconfident. I'm just the right level of confident.
I don't know how to move over to the other one.
For what? Our ship just accidentally slipped into the quarantine zone.
Oops, our navigation malfunctioned.
Oops.
How would we accidentally cross into the Nova Corps force field?
Details!
Nice gizmos, Rocket.
I'm calling them thumpers on account of the noise they make. Assuming we get past the force field and reach your coordinates in one piece, all we gotta do is set them up, and these babies are gonna draw out our monster in no time.
How's that even gonna work? The thumper goes beep, 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 and the monsters come running?
Like the Ghostbusters trap.
And then the monster comes a-running out of its hole.
Are you sure about that?
Hey, all my intel came from your source.
My sources are very reliable. Those coordinates are 100% pointing towards a rare, elusive, priceless creature.
With no physical description to go by.
What do you think elusive means?
Don't matter what the monster looks like. As long as it's got ears, you could be sure my thumpers are gonna drive it right into our arms.
So what we're doing is trapping a monster, and we're in a bad area of the galaxy that we're gonna get in trouble. Oh.
Peter Quill, we must soon discuss the status of my official team membership badge.
Drax, once again, there is no official badge.
Obviously, you would not have one, Assassin. The small one indicated the procedure is a well-guarded secret.
Rocket, stop messing with him.
Oh my god. There's so much copyrighted music.
Nice!
I'll pause it, so now no more copyrighted music in play. Oh, these are rooms? Oh.
Excited to meet our buyer after we catch the monster?
Not so sure about tooth cleaning tablets. Manual brushing is where it's at.
I thought it...
Morgoth, be with you!
Hey, Morgoth
cool.
Yourself!
I am cool.
Morgoth is a politeness thing? Catathian customs don't make no sense to me, bud.
She's only been here a few months, but her room's already decked out.
The Art of War. So there's definitely a lot of real media.
Hey, Groot, did that escort job on Orga ever pan out? What do you mean you never called her back? Don't know if you noticed, but we're flying.
Almost 20 years, and those tracks are still fire.
Wait, what kind of escort was that contract about? Yeah, maybe I'd rather be broke.
Nice. Rocket finally cleaned up the fur balls.
You're welcome!
Team costumes. You want how much for these things? When I said matching gold costumes, I meant gold colored, not actual crook-tacking gold. We want potential clients to think we've got wealth, not wear it right on our sleeves. That makes us a target. Here's the deal. When the time's right, we'll give these costumes a test run. If they survive it without any holes, I'll set up with you at, say, 6% of what you're asking. Best I can do. They look flarking amazing, by the way. I keep hitting X. I don't mean to do that. It's just what I had to do so much for the other game.
Did you bring back the docking chips you took from the alignment console?
I'll do it as soon as I reconfigure them!
Guys, there's so much dialogue.
Not like I'd make any money! Things are so cheap they couldn't align two magnetized connectors.
Yeah, the graphics are okay in this. I mean, they're fine, but they're not blowing me away. I feel like I'm
up here, Peter.
I feel like I'm still sort of playing the 1440p Series S here right now, even though I'm on a PlayStation 5. I mean, nothing looks super detailed. It looks good. It looks very. Whoa! Oh, and then I cut off dialogue.
That's my chair.
I'm cutting off dialogue a lot.
Oh, then why aren't you in it?
I was strategizing. It's one thing to get into the zone, but we still gotta catch that monster.
Right.
So did I miss anything?
Other than a ton of suspicious glares from Drax, not really. Now, if you're done strategizing, feel free to grab your seat. We're almost ready to go.
I want to check the other place first, then, if this is where we had to go. I can talk to her. I will. I want to, but I'm...
Our great leader ran away. Could you send him back?
Peter Quill, the murderess still calls your name.
Oh, sounds kinky.
I just want to look at the rest of the room, the rest of the spaceship.
Drax! About Gamora.
Can this not wait, Peter Quill?
What about Sodom?
Body for battle.
No.
You know we're supposed to capture this monster, right? Not kill it?
Of course.
but I suspect it will not go down without a fight.
Cool it, Muscles. Lady Hellbender ain't gonna buy damaged goods.
I will aim to preserve the integrity of the beast as best I can.
Good.
Oh, we're getting it for someone else who wants us to capture it? Okay. What the hell is this? What is this big black ball? The hell is that?
What is it?
Dude, take five. We gotta talk about that Gamora thing.
She's waiting for you in the cockpit.
I already checked in on her. You know you're not subtle with all that staring, right?
Subtlety is neither my strength nor my intent.
Look, I know you're mad about being on her team for the mission, but could you at least try to get along?
I doubt I would succeed.
All good, buddy?
I'm Groot.
You know, I don't understand you, Groot, but I'm going to assume you just said something super kind and thoughtful.
What did the tree say?
No idea. Groot really needs to get these plants under control.
This is Groot's room? This is his room. What? Try R3 to tuck? L3? Nope. L1? R1. L2? R2. Up on the D-pad? Down on the D-pad. Left on the D-pad. Right on the D-pad. Circle. Triangle. Oh, whoops, of course. Put that back home. Square. X. Alright. Let's close it. Let's leave it the way we found it. Whoa. This is where we go down to the Earth?
Good old Milano. Engine parts from at least five different black markets.
Okay, now go see this lady. We can turn pretty fast it's like a half second before it actually starts going pretty darn fast.
Ready now?
Now? Now.
Once we breach that force field, there's no going back.
Your black market codes are gonna crack that Nova net, right?
Yep. As soon as you enter them in your console.
Okay, here we go. Rocket, Groot, Drax, get in here. We're going in.
That's what she said.
For the next time window, actually.
The next one?
Novacore's security grid resets every rotation. We want to be in and out before our code expires, or we'll get stranded.
That's definitely what she said.
Next reset, we'll get a full rotation to do this. Nice.
Oh, why is the Novanet still up? Thought we were going in.
Well, it appears the assassin's contacts are as untrustworthy as the betrayer herself.
Oh, please don't tell me Gamora's backdoor codes are bust. We nearly went broke getting them.
Relax, Rocket. We still got a few ticks before the next time window.
The network just reset. You can enter the sequence, Peter. 0451.
Up, up, down, down, left, right, A, B, start.
Suspicious. Security measures are too simplistic for Novacore.
Oh shit, I already forgot. What'd you say? Oh shit.
Only works on this day.
Oh shit, what'd you say?
Oh,
I wasn't paying attention.
I get it. Gamora's codes are more like an encryption.
Oh shit, what'd you say?
Trying to integrate temporal coordinates in our ship's hard-coded serial to a local number generator.
Info gets in, digits come out.
Four of them.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for them to be like, hello.
Difficulties, Peter Quill.
Yes. I gotta wait for them to say it again.
Four, five,
whoa, the hand, that's cool.
Two, two, one, eight.
No.
Do not confuse the rodents.
I am Groot.
There.
That's the ship that's outside the, okay, yeah, now I see, that's the ship that's outside of the roller coaster ride in Disney World in Florida. I say in Florida because I'm not referring to Disneyland in California.
Real realize there was so much stuff left after the war.
Restraint wasn't very popular in the Chitauri army, especially with Thanos in charge.
Yeah, it's probably all harmless now.
I don't know any of that stuff about
12 years to get him heavy-duty explosives, right?
That's why I like...
This is after Thanos? I don't know much about any of that.
Oh, the wonderful and terrible things I could do with all this tech.
Stay focused, Rodent. We did not come here to scavenge.
Why not?
Oh, no.
These weapon systems could use an overhaul. Plus, there's good money in it.
The beast that we seek is far more valuable to the Monster Queen of Sekhnov 9 than any illegally acquired salvage.
But it would be a bonus to have both, I would think.
Place is really shifty.
I'm not seeing a monster, but that big cylinder up ahead looks like the mining ship Peter's friend said to look for.
Friend?
For a night? And you'll see the monster as soon as we place Rocket's monster summoning thing.
Rockets.
Mark yet.
California.
Suit up. Team Rocket's up first.
I still do not understand why I must remain on board with the assassin.
Ugh. Because you're part of Green Team.
You assigned me to the team before you named it. My skin is not green. It's teal.
Teal? Listen, if we want to trick the monster into going inside that mining rig, we need to place thumpers on both sides. Two sides, two teams.
That's our cue. Let's go, group.
Oh, there's the black orb thing. Okay.
Oh. Don't worry! Once the thumpers are placed, we'll meet in the middle and we'll capture the monster. Together.
Very well.
Looks like the air purifying mask from Dyson. Just with eyes. I mean, it's a beautiful looking world, but the graphics just, they look pixelated and mushy. There's detail, it's just...
Mora!
I'm not blown away by any of this.
Ah!
R3 track advisor. Whoa.
What?
Press R3 to turn on your visor.
Designed to keep all this war stuff from floating away.
Also, this is just the text of the menus. In visor mode, the compass is displayed at the top of the screen.
Nova Corps once wanted to cover entire planets in NovaNet, just like this place.
Yeah, the big hat like menus remind me of
I am Groot.
Visor works.
Sure it works. I checked it right before we left.
Did you just
can we take that?
In quotes?
What? No.
Something was scanned.
Yep. Being here definitely feels a little weird.
Yo, Quill! These coordinates are so reliable. How come we're the only ones out here trying to catch this thing?
We're the only ones crazy enough!
Might as well just stay in this mode so I can scan everything. Yeah, but anyway, so that this menu being very thick text and simple... There's not too much texture on the windows. Aggressive cluster foam developed to bond piece.
Walk on, mostly. That's why green
will continue to expand. Hmm.
Come on.
Oh quick. Shit.
We still got three more thumpers to place.
Oh.
Once this.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh shit.
Taking the
Oh.
You okay, Quill?
Yeah, I think so. This pink resin stuff's definitely strong enough to hold this place together.
Oh yeah. Definitely probably strong enough.
Oh god. Oh, Jesus. His jump feels so short. Stumpy.
Try harder.
There's a loot right there. How do I get that? Right there, the loot. How do I get it? Wait, what was that about high damage? High damage range. Yeah, let me punch the white stuff. I want that stuff. I want... This stuff right there. Right there.
Just imagine what kind of blasters the Chitauri had to use to wreck some of these frigates.
I am Groot.
Whoa.
I'm not being insensitive.
Oh, there's a double jump. What this?
You find something we could sell?
Nah, just some old correspondence. You know how I like to brush up on galactic war history.
No. Don't think I've ever seen you read anything without pictures.
Is there going to be this much talking through the whole game? Like, there's a lot of talking. I've cut off talking while trying to just move around the world because there's so much talking. I wanted to open this up and possibly read it, and he's talking through it. And I gotta say, if there's like a lot of talking every time I open something up and I want to start reading it and they're talking, I'm just then just not going to want to read it. Like, already I kind of don't want to read it.
No? Don't think I've ever seen you read anything without pictures.
I read plenty of non-picture stuff.
Yeah, like you can turn real slowly by barely pressing on it, and then all of a sudden it goes super fast.
You mean the Ebrium-based nano-resin cluster foam?
There's no, like, nothing...
Not if it stays outside you. Just don't eat any, or get any in your eyes.
Was I supposed to hear people? Because I'm seeing... Hold on. Is this happening where, like, stuff is supposed to be coming through my controller again? Controller speaker. Enable comlink audio through the controllers. Exactly. I knew there was something going on, so hopefully that will allow us to hear. How do they do that? Don't most of us wear headphones while we're playing? Maybe not.
Rendezvous?
Yeah, that's the mining rig.
So weird seeing it all clustered together like this. Bits and pieces of a war that spanned the entire galaxy held together by pink goo.
Ebrium-based nano-resin.
What? I'm just saying, it's a lot to take in.
That's what she said.
After we sell the monster... Whoa! Look! Yellow and blue! Looks like an old Novacore frigate. Nice!
Come on, dude. People probably died on that ship.
Killjoy, why do you even bring us here if the place is so sacred? I can name at least a dozen planets with monsters on them, so why here? You think it's to impress Gamora? Like, hey, check out the serious intel I got from, you know, shady sources.
Flap broke, Rocket. We need a big break. Aren't you tired of eating Yarrow root?
It's so... mealy.
Listen, this is a restricted zone. Whatever monster lives here, nobody else has one.
Lady Hellbender values rarity in her acquisitions.
Exactly.
Okay, so I had a couple things to say, but there's so much talking.
I told you, we ain't gonna get caught. There's only like 3 ships left in the entire Nova fleet.
Nova Corps has more than 3 ships.
Sure, but you know, they ain't half the space cops they once was. Can hardly keep...
I'll just have to cut them off this way, I guess. God, now I'm like forgetting what I wanted to say. One, is there gravity where we are? Because we're walking on things, we're jumping, and when we jump, we fall down. But then there's all this stuff just floating around next to us. The carts are floating around next to us. And two, yeah, that there's so much talking that, like, there was that thing. I saw the face immediately with the square. And I was like, I don't know what that is. I'm sure it's going to, like, start something else, maybe a dialogue or something, but they're talking right now. I want to hear what they're going to say, and I don't want to cut what they're going to say off. But it does cut them off. But it was running out. I didn't want to miss my opportunity to play that, so why did they do that?
...their own piece without worrying about some old graveyard from the war.
You're going to tell me to double jump here. I already learned it. I wonder if you can, like, oh, low damage range. I forgot to see it. I don't see any bullets, so all right. Whoa! X. Oh God, I want to make sure I had the right X. I got so used to the...
A very late war casualty.
Not funny.
But why would I fall? That's what I don't understand. How would I fall? All these other yellow things are floating. Why am I not floating?
Every- Everybody keep an eye out.
Whoa, what was that?
Craft or components.
Okay, well there you go, so I can do this then. So you're saying I can...
Monster is the first priority. I'm just saying, if you
see
anything good along the way, pick it up.
What was the circle? Alright. No, it's fine. That's fine. I cannot crouch. Maybe you'll teach me to crouch and we'll come back there. I think this is a hidden area back there on the right.
Hanging out, just like when we started this gig. Before you know who joined us.
I am Groot.
I do not hate everybody. I tolerate Quill. Quill's a swell guy.
I hope you get that promotion, Rocket.
Come on, Rocket. Drax and Gamora are valued additions to the team.
You're only saying that because she's listening.
Is that why your plan has Drax and I taking the ship?
Careful on that thing, Quill. You spot something out there?
More blue and gold. More Nova Corps.
Yeah, well, at least the dead ones can't arrest us.
There's the mining rig.
Any sign of our monster?
Not yet.
Ew, what was that?
I
mean, it's cool that we're traveling. Okay, well.
Pretty sure that way's a dead end.
Dead end. Then we're gonna do.
There we go. Path this way. Come on.
How can you even tell?
Just trust me, all right? Hey, Groot. You think we could find pieces of the Trion Shard in here? You never heard of the Trion Shard? Pyramid of pure evil. Corrupts everything it comes in contact with.
I am Groot.
You happy, Quill? You found the thing. I told you was there, but you didn't listen.
The mythical void. Death's black terminal. I would rather be there with you.
What? Drax, wrong kind of end. And it's not like you could have known, Rocket. Both ways were going in the same direction.
Maybe to you.
Yeah, I like that, like, we're kind of on this path, but we're in space. We're, like, there's just emptiness all around us, rather than walking on a path where we're, like, on...
Walk of shame!
We're, like, on a...
I told him!
Or we're, like, on a planet. You know, a regular planet walking around a big city or whatever. We're walking around in all this space. I think that's kind of cool. I write this report so that the efforts and the courage of my people may echo throughout time. We had finally accomplished the unthinkable. After generations of war, we put aside our differences and united to achieve our dreams. I'm dictating this message from the first interstellar Beeldarian vessel. Our pride, the Starburst. Everything we suspected was true. There are people out here. Countless other worlds. Some of them far more advanced and some of them struggling as we did. We were welcomed with open arms by a group calling themselves the Nova Corps. To our honor, we learned the galaxy itself is currently at war. Beeldar is right in the path of the aggressors, a violent race called the Chitauri. We requested aid from our new allies, but their rescue force will soon be intercepted by a much larger Chitauri fleet. We've decided to rapidly burn our fuel reserves to reach the Chitauri first. In our naivete, we did not have weapons on the Starburus, but she's fast and she's built strong. We will ram their capital ship. Perhaps we can save our new friends. Know this. For a brief, incredible moment, Beeldar found peace. We accomplished everything we set out to do. I pray our sacrifice will make a difference in our final hour. Oh my god. They killed themselves to protect us. Holy shit.
You done gloating?
Oh, I am never done gloating.
I am Groot.
I bet I'll be able to update, upgrade my booster to jump further.
Yeah, I'm sure it's safe-ish. Safer than flying with Gamora anyway.
I heard that.
Oh, this is the way we're supposed to go? But they came from over there. How did they come from that way?
I have not encountered any corpses in the wreckage.
Probably got disintegrated when the ships went to boom. Or the nano-resin absorber.
Oh, shit.
Well,
I'm okay. I'm okay.
Oh, but there's stuff down here, though.
Aw. You were worried. It's cute.
Shut up, both of you.
It almost feels like a platformer type game where like there hasn't been obstacles really to duck under, but there's obstacles to like jump over. And things into things. Uh-oh. Hold R2 to fire your elemental.
No worries. But watch your step, guys. This junk isn't as stable as you think. Take that, brittle.
I have to hold it to bring it up. Brittle. So that's how I shoot the white stuff. Back where we started, okay. And they can overheat.
Ugh. I hate these ship-eating parasites. Flarkas would chew right through the Milano in 2 cycles.
Was that like old-timey video game?
50 units says I can clear more of these suckers than you.
As if. Whoa, what the? Rocket, did you do that?
The scoreboard? You like it? Hacked it into the visor cover last time you
did. I thought I heard his own.
You hacked into my stuff?
Considering how many times I fixed the Flarkin thing, it might as well be my stuff.
Flarkin thing.
Optimal thumper placing distance should be just up ahead. I'm thinking right in front through the giant hole.
All right, that I am Groot
cockpit used to be
is getting repetitive and annoying. I get it. That's the only words he says. That's his language or whatever, but my fifth investigation into our grand quarantine zone, ebrium-based nano-resin cluster foam experiment is complete, and I can report that my material is performing as expected, if a little slow. The various debris here, mostly consisting of wrecked vessels, has begun to compress and bind together with the protective sphere. The soft materials aboard these ships have been significantly dissolved, and many of the harder metals are showing significant structural weakness. Before long, they should begin to start collapsing, their pieces pulled together and bound by the nanoresin. Again, I recommend that if NovaCorp insists on patrolling the sphere, they do it externally. It is not safe. We also need to discuss long-term disposal once the sphere is sealed permanently. Even though its contents will be rendered unusable, some of the more hazardous materials within will not be rendered inert. For this reason, I'm against the proposal to push it into a star. We don't know what kind of reaction that might cause. Instead, I propose we launch it into Nowhere's Rift, where it should theoretically cease to exist.
Well, that's grim. Try not to think about it. It's better not to wonder what happened to anyone working on these old wrecks. It was a long time ago anyways.
This is where we were supposed to go? I thought they looked like they were waiting out here to keep going this way, but I guess that's as far as we're supposed to go. Okay. Wait, what's down there? Is there a secret down there? Can I go down there? His grunt. What are you grunting for? Your jetpack's doing all the work, I thought. Oh shit! Oh shit!
Amazing! I should have been recording! Bridge over! I want to see if he's alive! I don't know, but he's twitching. Flarkin, Scott! You okay down there?
Yep. Yeah, just, thought I saw a shortcut.
Right.
Go ahead without me. I'll catch up.
No. I'm sick of the things where we split up. I want to be with my friends.
Nova Corps missile bay just on the other side. We'll meet you there.
Yellow and blue missile bay. Got it.
But I'll see if they're shooting any white thingies because.
How much of the war did you
see? Because I got a score above me.
The bits that happened as I was doing other jobs.
So he crouches automatically. Okay.
Going through creepy old ship. No big deal.
Easy there, Quill. Pretty sure nothing's gonna jump out at you.
And
maybe me and Groot.
Why isn't that one of the things?
Attacked by strange creatures when installing a thumper.
Now this brings back memories.
A little like a sports watch thing or a...
Alright, Rocket. Just set up another couple of thumpers.
All you do is try to shoot the floor.
Trying to bring the whole place down, Quill.
I interrupted them again. Great.
I get it.
I shot a thing.
Toolbox.
I interrupted them, though. I want to hear what they were saying.
You're gonna lure SWAT if they're in the wrong place.
Don't worry. Drax took notes.
They are rich in detail.
And rich in cock. Nice.
Aw, hey, little guy.
I shoot. Use R to aim, then hold L2 to lock onto a target. You lock on that way? Interesting.
We can hear your woozy squeal even without the phone.
A little busy!
So there's no aim assist. The game has aim assist built into its mechanics.
It was this weird blobby thing.
I don't have to keep... That's why I should be allowed to just aim myself.
One last freaky eye thing!
I guess the issue is that it could overheat or something.
Bang! Got one!
Yeah, like I'm overheating right now. Okay. Well, not even.
I think we saw one of those.
Bye bye, little guy.
Everything okay over there?
Encounter.
He got himself eaten by a blob or something. Should've heard him squeal.
You must fight with dignity, Peter Quill.
Or at least die with it.
Not funny!
I didn't know we could run through here. That's...
Hey, Drax! What makes you so sure this...
Oh, I could have flown, I guess.
Fire monster.
Her name is Lady Hellbender, and her collection of rare creatures is outdone only by the wealth she showers on those who...
They're probably coming out of this.
Someone was paying top unit for weirdos. I'd know about it.
Is an honorable warrior, not one of your back alley hooligans.
Don't talk about no, I go that way. Well, we got a lot riding on your gal pal's mystery monster tip. I hope she's legit. Like you could even tell if she had an honest face.
Trust in the plan, guys. Everything has checked out so far, right down to the mining ship. We put our thumpers in the right places, and we'll bag that monster.
Quill knows all about putting thumpers in the right places. And getting monsters. Come on! What are you waiting for?
I don't know how to get on this in a balancing way. Okay, there we go. Do I actually have to hold like left and right or tilt my...
Are you kidding me?
Son of a smash! That was too close! You okay, Groot? Well,
we're fine, but we can't jump that!
You don't gotta jump! There's a sturdy support beam on this side! Get Groot to grow a bridge across. Just ask him nice-like. He does it for me all the time.
Ooh.
All right, Groot. Let's see that cool vine.
So we are going to stay partners sometimes.
Gross.
These little...
Ship eaters.
These little butt boxes. He got little butt boxes.
Back to business.
No, no, no.
Right under your nose.
Fuck. I don't want this guy to beat me.
Chewing up all this beautiful
so it's those things. Okay, it's not just the white stuff. Alright. I'll try to beat him. I don't know where the checkpoint is. Maybe it's right there after they...
Gross! More ship eaters! They're everywhere!
Move it.
Alright! Back to it! Let's go!
Why the enthusiasm?
Because our bet's still on, and I'm gonna kick your butt.
Not when I can reset checkpoints. How do I... L1?
All this
R1?
We gotta go that way, across the gap, somehow.
Gap to gap. Yeah, Groot, how is it? L1, R1? Oh shit, sorry.
That we're worthy of Lady Hellbender's collection.
Yeah, it's close enough for Groot to bridge if you can find a proper handhold.
Handhold?
Peter Quill, the double agent is trying to lull me into a false sense of security.
Right. And the moment you drop your guard, I'll strike.
Look for one of them support bars on the other side there. Gamora, when are you gonna share your contacts and sources?
When will you share yours?
What? You know about all my guys.
I thought my L1 button wasn't working, so I have to be on there. When I press that button, that's a lot to edit out, I guess.
Groot, I found a hitch. Can you latch onto it?
Hey, greenies. You see any blue and gold ships out there, you let us know.
We have seen many such ships.
He means active ones. We haven't talked about what to do if we run into a Nova Corps patrol.
We will restrain them until you're done here.
Bad idea. Those cops are all connected through their stupid helmets.
If they do spot us, all they have to do is close that barrier and we're stuck.
If you see cops, you...
See, it interrupts again. I don't like that.
Leaving us behind.
Flark that!
Trust me.
Flark.
I've dealt with Nova Corps before. Even helped them catch real criminals. I can talk my way out.
You think the Milano can outrun a fully powered Nova Centurion?
She's done it before.
Are you scanning for targets?
Yes.
Where are you going, you Zarnook? Get back here and help!
Can I, like, do wall runs? I hope so. Oh, whoops. Mini boss time.
Here we go.
All right, set her down right there. Yep, one to go.
Flark!
No, no! Flark and Skaggy! Kratak and batteries fried, that's what's wrong. Maybe you put it-
Defend us while we-
The solution's a new battery, with a charge.
Okay, we're on what's left of a ship. Full of ship things. Gotta be things that power ship things around here, right?
Yeah. Maybe you're gonna want to use your visor for this. You find a replacement while I finish scraping the fried wires.
Scan objects of interest with R2.
So much for that.
So it's this yellow thing here, I guess.
Found something with a charge! Kinda looks like a spacey car battery.
Lucoid or xenon cell.
Okay, this thing isn't gonna zap me, right?
I didn't answer him.
Chances minuscule, at best. You'll be fine.
Here you go.
That'll do nicely. Just let me tinker a bit. I'll have to do some tweaking once I see how much juice this thing puts out. So watch my back.
Watch it from what?
I told you, defend your position, I knew.
Rocket! Help me scramble some critter!
No. Hold L1 to open Guardians mode.
If I don't rewire this fast, it's gonna short circuit! Fucking monster things! Everyone get ready!
I am dead!
That's a double, okay. Groot is a vigorous defender, able to withstand high amounts of damage as he focuses on crowd control. His basic ability, Entangle, immobilizes enemies in a small area for a short time, okay.
Lights out, eyeballs!
We're just killing party favor!
There is a lot of drop frames going on.
Fix this thing! I'll keep coming!
That's what she said. How do I know when he's able to...
No, right. Oh.
How do I know when he's able to do crowd control again? Oh, I can't. Oh, quick dash, okay. Right.
Long does it take to shoot, Scott?
Savor the joy of battle, Brute.
Oh, I was up in the air for a long time.
Easy for you to say. You've got a pointy stick.
Keep him away from that missile, Brute.
Don't blow yourself up.
Ground him up, Brute.
Done.
I don't know if you can like see his cooldown. I'm sure it's somewhere.
I'd like to see you fix it next time.
New tutorial page available. Hold to see now.
Two to go.
Oh. Oh, melee attacks. That was the square. I didn't even see the square tutorial button. I saw it that I could do it when I happened to hit square, and then it happened.
That passage, bud. Well, we found a way out.
I don't know why there's so many dropped frames.
All the risk we're taking for this job.
When these graphics aren't.
Are nearly unkillable, but
guys, we deliver this monster to Lady Hellbender, we'll get bigger payouts and jobs that don't suck.
A ship for each one of us.
I mean, a team only needs one ship.
Perhaps a more spacious ship.
What? No! I love my baby!
We can modify her. Kill for a Gunner's Rotunda.
We'll think about it.
I'm Groot.
Groot wants a plant.
Groot, man! We will get you two plants!
I'm Groot.
Man! That thing is ridiculous! Think it was a ship or a robot?
That's a pre-century.
We're on the hand right now.
It would have been space-worthy. That ain't even the biggest one. They designed at least 5 experimental models twice that size.
Impressive, but I could fly circles around something that big. Give me a fast and sexy M-class scout over those things any day.
I do appreciate that sweet Ravager pirate tech. She's made for hit and runs. And boy, can she run.
She can hit too.
There's always room for more firepower, Quill. That sentry probably took on whole fleets. This old Kree tech gets me wondering. Where would I be now if those blue butt spikes managed to keep me locked into their half-world experiments? Yeah, chances are you'd be climbing over bits of me right now.
Groot, need you to shoot a bridge right into that eye socket.
Now, I want to see you do that to something in combat.
No, I'm trying.
Is that... Yeah!
It wasn't letting me aim. I was just stuck looking at something else.
Man! That...
The hell was that?
Ridiculous!
Whoa.
Think it was a ship or a robot?
Why couldn't I shoot what I wanted to shoot?
A robot, but it would have been space-worthy. That ain't even the biggest one.
Impressive, but I can fly circles around something that big. Give me a fast and sexy M-class scout over those things any day.
I do appreciate that sweet Ravager pirate tech. She's made for hit and runs.
But that's alright. That it saves it?
She can hit too.
There's always room for more firepower, Quill. That sentry probably took on whole fleets. This old Kree tech has me wondering. Where would I be now if those blue buttscots managed to keep me locked into their half-world experiments?
I'm Groot.
Groot, need you to shoot a bridge right into that eye socket.
Wait. Shoot!
I'm about to win this bet, Quill!
How the hell is he at 4?
All this firepower. Now it's all just scrap.
I am Groot.
Dang it.
Sorry, bud.
Sorry about what?
Groot's people never even got a chance to fight. Whole Dastin plan was important at the start of the war.
You're good.
Oh, shit.
We're inside a giant robot head.
And I got robot parts inside my head!
You have robot parts inside your head. Inside a giant robot head!
Ha-ha. You guys are so...
Oh shit! He found more? Damn it.
Maybe this is the Parasite Clubhouse!
9? What the hell is he finding?
I'm having the time of my life! Quill, shoot down the nest if you're having-
Oh shit.
Speak for yourself.
I hate that he's beating me. And now he's not, but still.
Bam!
7? Where, what now is he finding?
I'll be doing with my winnings. I'm saving up for our next stop on Contraxia to get one of those Zeronian massages.
Ugh, you're so predictable.
How's that bet going over there?
I look forward to one of you winning, then perhaps this senseless chatter will cease.
Turn off your radio if you're not happy.
I take no orders from you.
God, how the hell did he get to 15 already?
You know what, Quill? I think it's unfair. You got 2 guns, I got 1. I think my points should count double from now on.
That's cheating!
All right, bump there, Quill.
It's not gonna piss off every critter around, right?
Sorry, Quill. Not taking no chances after the last one. I gotta test it real quick.
Not again.
Hey, bumper ain't gonna install itself.
Rocket!
I only flipped the switch on and off to see if it started.
Yeah, tell them that.
Gotta love that kill radius.
Rocket is a weapons expert who attacks from a distance. He focuses on damaging multiple targets at a time. He's basically ability, his basic ability, Cluster Flark Bomb, deals moderate damage. So I should get them all tied up with Groot and get them all shot with him. Hello. I'm hitting X to continue, it not working. Oh, there's the cooldowns. I see them now. All right, very good. I'm in front of the cooldown thing, but why are we still in slow motion? Am I doing that?
Darn it! I thought we were safe. Oh, come on! Now we gotta deal with junk slugs?
Don't gawk at it. Shoot it!
Don't just look at it. Eat it.
You're welcome. Stop distracting me.
Rocket! Newgum!
I knew I was missing all the fun last time!
Hey! I'm happy to take this round off!
See? I knew you'd get into it!
How do I log onto an enemy?
Yeah! I'm gonna murderize the lot of ya!
Watch where you're shooting!
Good! Incoming!
Hold them down,
Groot! We really need to test these things!
The testing is the most important.
Sorry to burst your bubble! Take this!
I lock on just by holding the right trigger. Oh, Jesus.
At least they make a good splat!
Amateur!
I'm kicking them.
Stop the short, Groot!
I knew I was missing all the fun last time!
Don't forget about that bumper!
Nice splatter, Rocket!
I know, right? What was that worth? 5 points?
Oh, come on! Get
wait, what?
Points like that.
He's ahead of me now? Oh, Shumasa, you received an ability...
We'll meet you at the mining ship.
You received an ability point. Use the pad to access the Guardian's menu and unlock your first ability. Every 1,000 XP will grant you a new ability. Oh, okay, so it's not like for level 2 I need to get 1,500 or something. That's cool. Use them to unlock new skills. 4 team members. What about for me?
What's the mining ship doing in the middle of all these fighters anyway?
Ding. Fighters.
War for nothing.
Press X to select Peter Quill and access his... Okay. You currently have one ability point. Reach 1,000 XP to unlock another. Hold X to spend one ability point and acquire the Vantage Point ability. So that's what I have to... That's it. Okay. Star-Lord initiates a prolonged burn of his jets, rising to a tactically advantageous position to give orders or attack enemies. My first Guardian's trophy, too. Swap Guardian. Can I play as them? No, it looks like you're just upload. Okay. Got it. Damn it, I was winning.
I can hear your visor working. Better not be cheating on our bet, Quill.
How can you hear that?
I'm looking around for everything else.
All right, mining rig is right there. Of course it's secure. As secure as a broke down Chitauri shipwreck's ever gonna be.
Oh, Jesus. To get ahead of me because I don't want them to shoot things before me.
The resin can hold a stupid warship.
I'm telling you, it's totally safe. See? I'll even prove it. Huh? Look at this.
Who didn't see that coming?
Oh, fuck.
Nice jump!
Thank goodness for my extra powerful space thingy. He's gonna be mad that I didn't save him.
Groot! Groot!
I don't understand why it's dropping. Everything else is floating. I don't get it.
Buddy, you're okay!
Only little tiny light things can float?
Fine.
But we're too heavy?
You flarkin' piece of moldy driftwood! You could have died saving me!
I love you too, you selfless son of a jock. Come on, Quill. He says he'll meet us at the mining ship. I don't want to make him wait.
Shoot.
You're not going after him?
He says it's fine. We'll meet him later.
Team Rocket, is everything okay? Groot's signal just went dark.
His radio must have broke when he fell.
What happened to your timber companion?
He ain't
wait, he's shooting too? He's a 20? Or no, he was a 20.
I don't know if you're being clever or dumb right now. Team Rocket, out. Sounds like Green Team's off our backs. Now we can stop worrying about that dumb accident. Groot's fine anyways. There's nothing to worry about.
An accident, Rocket? Come on!
What?
That's all it was!
It's your fault! If you hadn't fooled around on that ship...
I did it! You don't know nothing! Stop trying to be smart!
That sure didn't sound like an apology.
Nope!
No way! Oh, I see it in there, uh-huh. I see it through there.
Hard to believe all this destruction's because some ugly flarkin' bugs got uppity.
It was a little more complex than that.
And I need to scout for those things, too.
Everything at the bug homeworld and exterminated the flarkers.
We did, but they surrendered.
That don't change my opinion on the matter.
Oh, shit.
Imagine towing all this scut by hand. Or by ship, technically.
Maybe they retrofit their star blasters with Nova Force gravitational shovels.
Huh. I need group back.
Hey, look, a shortcut we can't use because somebody lost group.
So useful you would have pointed out. Thanks!
You're welcome. Man, if that afterburner kicked on right now, we'd be toast.
Mining ship's on the other side of that turbine, so we gotta find a way through.
Try not to jump on anything this time. Groot's not there to grab you if you...
Well, either shut up or help me figure out how these blades open.
I see right here, I'm sure. I don't know. I thought you crouched automatically. Fine.
Lots of Chitauri ship husks out here on the edges.
There's a drone access tunnel over here.
Oh, I gotta tell him to go?
Got a drone.
Can you squeeze in there?
That's what she said.
Fix the thing.
That's what she said.
Rocket, crawl into the mystery hole.
See anything?
Yeah. Mystery hole. That's my favorite kind of hole.
One of our cover points was covered in resin, so we're gonna fly around and scout another spot.
Just make sure the new spot as close as possible to the original one. Because of...
Sorry, my camera's all crazy.
Great. Another turbine.
Yeah, that's
my favorite looking area so far.
Usually built.
This thing's gonna start spinning, I'm scared. I'm like a giant hamster. Oh, okay, let me get off of it.
Winning? Feels like I could be winning.
I mean, it's your tech doing the counting. Pew! Pew! You know, we make a pretty dynamic duo, Rocket. Come on! Let's get out of here.
I feel like I recognize this voice of the guy playing Star-Lord.
Am I the only one who's fed up with how much this entire junkyard stinks? We're back on track. The mining ship ain't too far.
I'm looking for things to shoot to stay at. Oh shit!
Hope he didn't get distracted. I've been thinking about buying the elite.
Oh shit!
Grab!
It wasn't me this time, I swear!
I guess I can just dodge around it, but I thought I had to shoot. Oh, yeah! He just got a point, damn it.
This thing with muscles I didn't even know I had!
What is he shooting? Hey! That's... How is he getting points? Oh.
Larkin, son of a...
I told you I saw that.
Great timing! How did you guys...
Good to see you two. You're gonna run across the ship as fast as you can.
Oh, shit. Wait, run. I can't do my circle shoot.
Yeah, Scott's gonna-
He's a 24. God damn it.
Just try to hold her still.
I hate this fucking fox.
Position is untenable.
Fuck this fox. Oh shit.
No! Keep running!
That looked like a visual problem. It didn't look like proper shaking.
Well, this way!
Team Rocket! Can you make it inside?
Yeah. All in one piece.
Got it. Meet you in a tick.
No rush. It's nice and cozy in here.
You're gonna teach me to use flashlight.
Can't see in the dark.
Ah, I think I felt the panel. Yeah, there's wiring in there. See if I can get the systems back on.
How long is this gonna take?
Oh, come on! Larkin tensor joint, just neat.
Wiggle the... Okay, so life support's moving back up. What's it look like out there?
Holy mother of space bar.
I won? That's gonna be the last of the things to shoot? Oh, thank God. Thank God I won.
Quill, you okay?
Yeah, it's just...
Little fuzzy thing. Pet it. Give it love. Uh-oh. Oh, boy. The hell did that?
Well, that's concerning.
It's like a rival. But a little different, but still kind of like a rival. Alien on the other side of this glass.
Old cleaner bots. Maybe.
Like the Roomba?
Cleaner bots.
I don't know.
Like a Roomba. They're cleaning robots. They clean up. They bump and bop into the walls and they keep on the cleaning. It's gonna be our friend. It'll be our friend. We all know. We should have called out first.
Hey, buddy.
Pick up your painful orange thing, put it in your fucking palm. Whoa, what was that?
That freaky thing we accidentally released.
Saw!
Where'd it go?
Saw some cleaner bots, accidentally, at a distance. We're totally all right. It just ran away when it saw us, right, Quill?
Rocket, I'm not so sure that swarm thing was inoffensive. I feel kind of bad about releasing it.
Quill took a pot shot at this massive worm nest. Chunk of something fell off and the big floating creature came out of it. That's all.
Oh my god, that looked like a Firewatch logo. You can change the Guardian's outfits via the outfits screen. Okay. I don't need to look at that yet.
Green team better be showing up soon. You didn't see them? They better not have left us in here by ourselves.
I am Groot.
Witcher Agilchop.
I am Groot.
Quill's dumb enough to lead us into a trap, but don't sweat it. Ain't nobody knows we're here. Here you go. Rendezvous coordinates are that way, but we'll have to find a way around the rubble.
I can already see it.
Side passage.
I already found it. I could see stuff through there. Through the little crack.
Look at this old beauty.
I am Groot.
A table. This is a vintage Model T engineering workbench.
This is where I can upgrade.
Dirty like that no more. Hey, come on, Quill. Let's see if this beauty still works. Maybe I can fix up your gear. Hey, hand me that part.
Oh, is the Firewatch logo behind there too? Okay. With Rocket's help, use a workbench to craft perks. So I need Rocket to craft perks? Available perks are displayed when you activate it. Each perk requires specific components to craft. Okay. I got a lot of components. This is the amount of each crafting component you currently have. Here's an available perk. You have enough components to craft this perk. Hold X to ask Rocks.
There might be something behind the big unit.
Negate cooldown period due to... Oh, yeah, okay.
One tick. Done.
This little pensive piano. Not with the rest of the orchestral and kind of slightly electronic-y tapping beat. That piano makes me think of the piano in Spider-Man when you're solving the science things. Quickly pressing R2 twice charges a shot, releasing to deliver a hit that inflicts both stagger and... Holy shit. I can afford that. I want to do that. Attract enemy drops from up to 15 meters away. Ooh. How far do I pick them up now? Firing rate doubled when health drops. Scan enemies during combat with a visor. Glide around targets for a short time while shooting. I feel like I already was doing that. Perfect slow dodge. Ooh. Avoid falling prone by dashing when hit with a knockdown. Drop additional health pickups when landing a lethal blow. Lethal blow. After a jet dash. Jet boot dash. Locate crafting components via tracking feedback and additional visor support. Oh. Health increase would be nice. Shield restoration rate. Do I want to spend almost everything that I have on something to help me find other things? I guess I'll wait on that. Some of these, quill punch when landing a lethal blow. That sounds like too, like, I don't know how to do that combat yet, so I'll wait on that. Air glide, I thought I was. I like the, charge shot. We'll do this one.
Ding, ding, done.
Quickly pressing it twice. Okay. Double press and hold R2. So tap, tap. Like that. Not tap, tap, hold. But tap, hold. I am assuming. Release R2 to shoot. Oh, really? Okay, so dun, dun. It charges. Boom. Okay. A charge shot inflicts, but let's try it. We'll try it right here.
Yeah, there's a way through if we can clear out that.
Oh, I had to hold it way faster.
That one stubborn bunch of lore. Try that quick cooldown I installed, so you can keep helping it. Come on, Quill, put them beam shooters to good use, so we can squeeze in there.
That's what she said. Okay, well. I can't do it because you want me to do something else.
I'm gonna bite your toes off. Why'd I even bother upgrading those things if you aren't gonna use them? You gotta time it just right to overcharge the phase coolant. Fastest gun in the Ionian cluster.
Oh, whoa, what was that?
Yeah.
What was that?
And
what was that?
The upgrade.
Oh, so I wait for it to get.
So that thing we set.
Okay, hold on, let me do that again.
Definitely don't want to talk about no thing.
That was still too short, too quick. Alright, so this is like Gears of War.
Remember to watch for useful scrap. If you ain't got enough pockets, get creative. I don't think you're gonna find another way through, Quill.
That's cool, man. Rapid reload allows you to cancel your element's gun cooldown and deal extra damage. Like Gears of War. Now I know. Because I've played every Gears of War except some turn-based version. Even Judgment. Firing repeatedly causes overheating. Upon overheating, green zones appear on the cooldown gauge. I wonder if you can upgrade it so that zone gets wider so it's easier to do it. Pressing R2 with a marker in this zone cancels the overheat. And gives you a super blasty blast. So what was the point of me getting the upgrade that I got?
I don't trust your definition of safe. Seems a little wobbly. You guys hang back a sec.
Well, Scott!
This place is crawling with ugly!
Oh my god.
Guys, I'm not alone down here!
I'm just punching it, okay. Oh my god.
Holy crap!
Oh shit, Jesus.
Punchable thing I've ever seen!
Trying to do the... Oh shit. I'm trying to do the double tap. I'm trying it again. Tap tap. What?
Sounds like you're having fun.
All right, I have to. I want to do the thing where I reload.
Right in the face, big.
Rocky, you really missed out. That was amazing.
My God, my health is low. Jesus, I wasn't even paying attention to my health bar up on the top left.
Been messing up our comms.
Oh my God, I pressed triangle to stomp it. I'm so used to Callisto Protocol.
Another hole.
Another one. I'm Milano, but Drax is out there searching for you.
Maybe you'll find Quill before we do. We're trying to catch up to him.
Guys, we really need to get better at the buddy system.
She is not my buddy.
I like the design of all these rocks on the wall.
Surroundings.
Makes me think of Control.
Metal, old mining equipment, just old.
Noted.
I know where to go. I know where to go up. I'm just looking around at other things. So I shoot this until I get the green. I have to do the green thing to bless this open? Or can I use my extra powerful thing? Oh.
I wonder if Rocket knows what this is.
Oh God, that scared me. Right when I started to jump up. You found the spinal control unit. Rocket might have something interesting to say about it.
Okay, it's some old equipment, but I do not see you.
This whole place is old equipment.
That does not narrow my search.
Goodbye.
Whoa, another freaking thing!
How freaky? Kill it!
You read my mind!
Wait, what is the white stuff?
This guy, I can barely scratch it!
Kill it harder!
I'm killing it as hard as I can!
I gotta punch it to like... It's gonna be like a, stun. The stagger bar is always placed below the health bar. Filling it completely will momentarily cripple them. Wait, huh? Why did the bar go away? I was waiting for it to be filled up.
Like
that's what she said.
Blaster fire!
Peter Quill, hide behind me! I will protect you!
Nobody's hiding!
Nobody's hiding?
Rip him a new one!
Dax is a durable brawler, able to take on many enemies at once. They're all able to take on many enemies at once. He specializes in staggering enemies, impervious to regular attacks. His basic ability, Destroy, deals light damage and heavy stagger. Oh.
Consternation, but no longer!
Uncanny! Look at me go!
Chef Fish is on the menu!
Sure
did. Oh shit, there's another one. Oh God.
Drax, destroy!
Oh my God, here we go.
My turn!
Okay, a sword is sharp. The triangle is sharp. Deadly
strike. Nice!
Order up.
Not too big to skewer!
Gamora is a skilled assassin who swiftly eliminates targets. She delivers quick, high damage attacks. Her basic ability, Deadly Strike, deals heavy damage to a single enemy. There's probably a long cooldown or something.
Found and saved.
Hey.
Go on ahead.
Hey.
Just making a pit stop.
I parked the Milano near the last thumper spot. We'll head that way and keep an eye out for you.
If we can get this thing down, it should give us the extra height we need.
Oh Oh yeah, that's somewhere. Locate an object for Gamora to cut. Oh.
All right, pretty sure that baby's our ticket upward. Somehow.
It's a possibility. Maybe try something else.
Or the wire itself. Well, how do I select the... I'm trying to highlight. There we go.
Let's see that fancy footwork, Gamora.
I was trying to move the cursor over and it wasn't.
That is physically impossible.
Hold on. Okay, why? To lift it?
Drax, think you can heft that container?
Oh, Jesus. Okay. What, like, to move it here? Oh, whoa, whoa.
Can you move it over there?
I am on my way.
Oh, interesting. Oh, that's a little...
Well, that's helpful.
I did as our leader bid. Not all of us are so quick to disobey.
What? Oh, yeah.
Are you mad I served Thanos, or...
Oh, wait, hold on. Got it, hold on, wait a minute.
Heave-ho, Drax! To where shall I move it?
Here looks good.
Shall be done.
Now it's like Kena Bridge of Spirits, only instead of a bunch of tiny little cute things, it's a big heavy dude. I keep holding L1 to run, because that was also... Callisto.
Can you hold some more stuff for me, Drax?
Where shall I relocate it?
Can you move it over there?
Understood.
So I have just jumped up on here myself. Whoa, this is where I started? Oh shit. Okay, hold on.
Whoop!
I thought I saw some green things floating.
Hey, big guy, lift that thing up.
With ease.
Need your muscles again, Drax. You can put it down here.
Done.
I like jumped on his head. I thought I saw things here too. There's definitely something up there. Okay. I wonder if he can like carry it up too. That would be interesting. Oh God! Why does it keep bouncing to me? Don't stop that.
Can you move it over there?
I am on my way.
And then once I get up there, ask him to bring it up. But can I like knock this wall down? Looks breakable, man. There we go. Oh, maybe I don't need it. Maybe I just go this way. Okay, there we go. Get a better vantage point. There's things up there?
Rocket?
Perhaps he has located our monster.
We don't even know what it looks like. The intel was extremely vague.
It wasn't vague, it was rushed. It's probably some cute little...
Nightmarish abomination.
Lady Hellbender is a renowned warrior. An ideal specimen will reflect that strength.
Like I said, something scary.
I disagree. Strength is endearing. My little Camaria and her mother Hovat were two of the strongest people who ever lived.
With a name like Hellbender, Gamora's probably right. It's gotta be something scary.
Nightmarish. A proper apex predator.
She doesn't like me, so I wanna, like, befriend her.
And all of us combined. Bat-like wings with razor tips. Probably spits poison or acid.
Or acid.
Poison or acid, bro. Tasty air.
Worthy challenge.
After the Chitauri destroyed our outpost, we journeyed for 15 rotations to reach the healer. Every night was harder than the next. As Jexlem's breathing worsened, we could find nothing medically wrong with him. The Chitauri saw that damaged his mind, and he was simply giving up. After he'd led us through so many battles, we weren't about to let him go out this way. We found his church aboard one of its converted mining ships. The line was long, but the excitement was palpable. Each time we advanced, we could hear screams of joy at the front of the crowd. When it was our turn, we approached this gold-skinned miracle worker. I do not have the proper vocabulary to describe him, but it is the closest we have ever been to divinity. The healer pressed his hands against Jexlem's forehead and whispered to him. Our friend's eyes widened, and he took a deep breath for the first time since he fell in battle. Oxo be praised, he was healed. Jexlem has been distant on our return trip. We believe he's simply dealing with his near-death experience. We hope he will be himself once again soon. Uh-oh, no, he was getting worse and turning into a monster that I'm gonna have to fight. God, I keep hitting L1 to run.
Hunting this thing kind of reminds me of this time when my hamster got loose and I chased her.
The hamster. Beast.
Yeah, she had a mean bite. Did you guys have pets?
I had an eyeball in a jar. It never blinked because of violence, but it always looked like it wanted to.
We got company.
Is this from the last thumper?
We haven't even placed it yet. Too far, quarry. It will not be far behind.
Let's just focus on not shoot ourselves.
We need to regroup.
No.
Right, this isn't working.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
You woke up the whole ship.
When your huddle gauge is full, trigger the huddle with L1 R1. Actions you perform in battle build up your huddle gauge. When filled, call a huddle to reset the odds. Oh god, okay.
Guys, huddle up!
What is happening?
They're everywhere, laughing at us!
Access the Guardian's mood. Wait, what? Choose the speech that best refocuses or cheers them on based on the words you see. What?
Fort Nerd's on the field. Danger on all sides. Then it's time we stand and face it and make sure they're nullified. Are we heroes to be laughed at? No! I'll laugh at them instead. Who's with me?
Feel my wrath!
Bring it on!
Time to...
Huddles have three possible outcomes. You motivated the team by answering correctly. This ACDC, both you and the Guardians get a damage boost. Had you chosen wrong, only you would have gotten it. Win, lose, or say nothing. All Guardians are resurrected. I get full health. No, this guy. Yeah, this.
I'll enjoy this.
String them up. Told you we could do this.
Nope, wrong one.
I wish I had beaten this one with its own tentacles! They're too up!
Oh shit.
I prefer to shoot!
There's a lot of things to remember to look at.
Ah! The final kill goes to me!
Glorious. Goddamn right, it's incredible. You're goddamn right. Engorged with the thrum of battle. Engorged.
Come on, last bumper spot is this way.
How do you know?
My senses are fine-tuned to measure even the tiniest vibrations.
He's still alive.
I'm tracking it on my display.
He's hooting.
The melodic should be right on the other side of this door.
That's fine.
I came through here.
I'm sure, but hold on, let me look around.
Says I tripped on something. Murder Mom probably closed the door behind me.
Excuse me?
Murder Mom? I was just watching Serial Mom. Can I get him to lift this thing? The L1's not working now, so I guess not.
Blades are eager to meet this monster.
Remember, we take it alive. No accidents this time. I don't want a repeat of Yormod.
Yormod was not an accident.
I am Groot.
Fine. Me and Groot were messing with some subsystems. I may have tripped something.
I am Groot.
I said I may have. Look, if it's got power to close, it's got power to open.
I am Groot.
We'll need a good staging spot for the last thumper. I'll know it when I see it.
It looks like it's still got some juice. Give it a go, Rocket.
Watch a genius at work.
You are a miracle worker, man.
This tech was built by people who make holes in giant floating space rocks.
I have to say, that is an immaculate parking job.
Thanos never tolerated imperfection.
Never been a problem for Quill.
Come on. Just let me go up there.
What do we do if this monster turns out to be...
What?
You would likely receive higher...
Let me up.
Hey, we ain't caging nothing that can complain about.
You and Groot are ex-bounty hunters.
Groot's right.
There we go.
That's different. They knew what game they were playing.
There's nothing up here. All right.
Yeah, yeah.
Dashing is like control too when dashing in the air.
This is it. Last spot.
Wait to be out of here. This place feels like it's about to collapse on itself.
I cannot wait to meet our monster.
I thought you were mostly interested in meeting the buyer.
She is a respectable collector.
Is it working?
Yeah, yeah. Don't worry, Sunshine. Ow!
Is it, doing it?
What?! Ain't nothing broke! That's the sound it's supposed to make!
What sound?
You can't hear that!
Hear what?
Oh, now boss time.
Catch our monster.
Is that how it goes? Like each level is like a why are these crates highlighted? Force the monster out of hiding. I don't want to shoot that.
I have missed the thrill of the hunt.
Good, because we're not leaving without our catch.
Why do you keep lining up on that?
This is the right creature.
Good thinking, Will.
Why is that good thinking? I don't understand. You don't want me to break these?
That's good news, Mike. It means it's worth something.
I don't know what this does.
Maybe try to keep that door left behind.
But it's still left. There might be some way to slow him down.
Find a way to capture.
We should have brought a net.
Remind me to build a net launcher next time.
I'll just stand in the corner where it...
I think it's playing with us!
A game we will win!
Could I use Groot to capture it?
I was expecting something bigger!
It makes up for it in speed!
Llama Wanglo. Aww.
What the flark is that?
Definitely not a monster.
His hair is in his face. You can't see.
Adorable. It's more matted than an Asgardian goat.
No.
Sent this pathetic creature to the monster queen of...
You chewing with this one little tooth.
Maybe we can use it as bait.
I knew those thumpers.
Why do I have to show those boxes?
My thumpers are state of the art. Musclehead's the one who rushed at the first thing that came through the door.
My head is not made of muscle.
Guys, seeing what I'm seeing?
The inside of a mask? No.
Yes. Now that is a monster.
Oh boy. Asante. Oh boy. You're like a little fishy.
Enough with the warm up. Time to catch us a real monster. Let's get paid.
Enough of the worm. Oh, the health bar is getting bigger. Oh, shit.
What in hell's name is that?
He just lost half his health.
Cleaner bots.
He's gonna find a way to... What? Now he just lost all of his health?
The whole place is crapping out. We gotta get out of here! Now!
Curse these volatile ruins!
Tracks, go!
Easiest boss fight ever. Ooh, you can change the controls of the Milano.
Watch, people! Rocket, hit the music! On it!
Focus on flying, Peter!
Someone play this man a song!
This is the song that was playing while we were on the roller coaster.
You ain't! Rex, wait!
I am holding my buttocks to keep your cool instruction.
What? Oh, I've overheated, that's why.
Someone give me a hand! Am I right?
How about inside the head? Heads up!
We have debris incoming! Blow it away!
I was reading it and I almost missed. Yeah, this is playing on a roller coaster.
Don't even think about it!
Like its way through is through!
Peter! You're dying with a guilty conscience, assassin!
Don't you get through on my ship! Look! That's it!
I run so far away.
Dead yet.
Maybe we are in this town.
Do not be ridiculous. This place lacks the eternal frost, Sardu.
Your hell is frozen?
The Tathians do not like to be cold.
Try putting on a shirt.
See? He's so...
Brute says watch out!
Yeah, thanks for the heads up!
Oh shit, did we just blow up? Ah shit.
See? He's so...
Brute says watch out!
Thanks for the heads up!
Where do you want me to go? I don't... Am I shooting debris? I don't... Oh, okay, there we go. Couldn't really see what's going on.
You want me to take the controls?
No, I've got this!
Clearly!
Watch it! Don't get us killed, Quill. There's still so much stuff I want to steal! We ain't gonna make it!
So I guess I can't really steal.
The one from the secret posters I added!
Can you please stop adding things while I'm asleep?
Touch it, Peter!
Now is not the time for-
And I can't really aim too much. It felt like I was supposed to be able to, like, steer and move way differently, but... It's really not too much. It's a little left, little up, little down, little right. That's about it. I thought I could turn and just go a whole nother way.
Maybe.
That's alright, this is still cool.
See? Hold stretch!
Trying to shoot those things, but they're not shooting. So maybe I can destruct that. I cannot. I'll save my... I don't want to overheat. Oh yeah, I can thrust more. That's what she said.
How's that a win? Our monster just got eaten.
Whatever you can fly away.
Like the sun is not...
Screwed up because you had to fly away from it.
Uh-oh. Something got us.
Please don't be Novacore. Please don't be Novacore. Please don't be Novacore.
It is Novacore.
All that before the title. I didn't even realize there wasn't a title yet. Oh my gosh.
Hallis Hope.
Did you say Hallis Hope?
That is a lot of music, a lot of talking, a lot of controls. Yeah. Okay, well, there you have it. There is my very first video playing Marvel Guardians of the Galaxy, the game, on the PlayStation 5. As always, as I think I always say, I'm pretty overwhelmed with all of the buttons and things and looking at menus. So hopefully it'll be something that I get used to. I never like feeling the way I feel when I first start playing a game. Sometimes I don't like feeling like I'm not going to be able to understand it, and I'm missing half of the story again because I'm trying to just grasp everything that the UI and the mechanics and all of that stuff. And for a while there, was like, mostly it took like seven of my videos before seven to finally understand what I needed to do. That's just me, I guess. That's just me. I think there's a little too much talking in the game. Too many people are talking and cross-talking, and I can't do anything without then cutting them off. So as much as there is too much talking, as I say, I also wish I could hear what they were saying and not keep cutting things off. The menu leaves something to be desired. I don't know, it's a little too flat for me. Just big, thick, chunky text with just sort of a flat color of a background. There's a little bit of a gradient in the menus and stuff, but it's kind of flat to me. I'm interested to see what other worlds we'll see. I assume that this world of this the ships and different ship components that have been stuck together by this space life form, and like all the little balls that we were shooting, I assume we'll have like more like human styled enemies, you know, things with arms and legs more than a lot of bugs slithering around. That was all really just to be a tutorial, since after all of that we see the title of the game. So I feel like that was all just a prologue sort of thing. It said act one, but I treated it like a intro prologue. So we'll see if we get to sort of like how when I played Gears of War, I thought we were going to shoot robots the whole time, but that was kind of the opening. So we'll see. I'm definitely going to play another video. And that's it. Okay, I'm Dan, First Person Looter, and this has been my very first time playing Marvel Guardians of the Galaxy on the PlayStation 5. I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.